Hello, you're on Pop the Spot. I'm George. Welcome to this series on Back to Basics on System Tools. On this episode, I will cover the installation and configuration of Asdf. I use Asdf to manage development environments on my machine, especially when I play around with different versions of programming tools. So if this episode and all other videos on this channel tickles your fancy, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and join me in the journey of learning by doing. So, let's do this. Some housekeeping before we start. Please bear in mind that I'm using Windows and I have Ubuntu Terminal for Windows installed on my machine. And the steps that I'll be showing here also requires that you have all my ZSH on your system. So I suggest heading to the episode on setting up Ubuntu Terminal on Windows, which you can access from here. I'll also add the link on the description below. And so once your setup is done, head back to this episode to set up ASDF. What is ASDF? Without having to dig into much detail, ASDF is a command line tool that allows for flexible managing of versions of programming languages and frameworks and tools on a per directory basis. In the past, when a programming language is installed on a system, the version gets applied system-wide. And with ASDF, you can have multiple versions of a programming language, framework, or tool for different directories. We will see how this works later, but for now, let me show you how I install and set up ASDF on my system. I have prepared a script to simplify the installation steps, so let me open my browser and go to that page. So let's dissect this script and see what it does. The first step in the script installs apt libraries that ASDF requires. The next step involves cloning of the ASDF GitHub repository into a hidden directory called .asdf inside my home directory. And then ASDF is added in the list of supported plugins in my ZSH run command file. And lastly, a ZSH session is initiated to run an ASDF update. So let me go ahead and run this script. So let me go back to my code. To get my installation to take effect immediately, I need to source my ZSH run command file. And to verify the installation, I can simply check which version of ASDF I have installed. So what I need to do next is to start adding plugins, which are either tools or programming language framework versions that I need. So for my case, I'll start adding plugins for awscli, Terraform, Python, and nodejs. To list down available versions of specific plugins that I can install on my machine, I need to run ASDF list all. I'll install two versions of awscli to illustrate how this becomes useful later on. So I'll install version 2.2.0 and 2.2.10. And I'll do the same with Terraform. Firstly, I need to list all available versions that I can install. So for Terraform, I'll install versions 0.15.5 and 1.0.0. And then I'll do the same set of exercises for Python. Then if I scroll up a little bit, just to list down the standard set of versions. So in this case, I'll install versions 3.8.11 and 3.9.6. And lastly, with Node.js, I'm going to install versions 15.14.0 and 16.5.0. Now, if I run Asdf list, this will show me the list of plugins and versions that I've installed and available for use with Asdf. Now let me show you where Asdf becomes very, very useful. This is where Asdf provides a solution for me to achieve productivity. This is also where it helps in unblocking me for any potential compatibility issues that I could face when I start writing code or use the tools or language frameworks that I've installed with Asdf. So let's clear this terminal. And I'll create two directories. Imagine each directory corresponds to a project that I'm working on, and each project has a certain set of requirements in terms of version of tools and language framework. So let me set up the first project. So I'll change directory to workspace one. And so I'll start checking the version of four different tool sets that I've just installed in Asdf. This message indicates that I have not set this workspace with specific version of AWS CLI yet. And if I run the same version check for all the other three tool sets, I'll get the same error message. What I need to do to set up these four tools in this workspace directory with specific versions is to run asdf local command. This will set the version of plugin to be applied inside this directory recursively. So let's go ahead and do that. What this command does is it creates a file in this directory called tool versions. So if we list down all the files inside this directory, let's have a look at what's inside the file. The asdf local command inserted an entry corresponding to the name and version of the plugin that I want installed in this directory. So now let me continue setting up localized plugins in this directory for the other three. Now let me show you how the tool versions file look now. The file contains all the plugin and versions that I have. Now that we know what this command does, this means I can actually directly edit the file for my setup. Now, if I start checking the versions of the plugins in this directory again, I should get proper results. So this is my setup for workspace one. Take note of the versions that I've used for each of the four tools that I've installed on this workspace. Now, I'll change directory to workspace 2 and perform the same set of steps that I've done on this workspace. What I will do different here is I'll be using the other version of the four tools on this workspace. So let's go ahead and clear this. And like what we saw earlier, if I check the version of the plugins on this directory, I'll get the error message of missing version set. And now I'll install a different set of plugins on this directory. Now let me check the version of these plugins again. So what this signifies is that I can work on different projects that use different versions of tools and language framework without having to make switches, reinstallations, or reconfigurations of my system. For example, Workspace 1 requires Python 3.8.11, while Workspace 2 requires Python 3.9.6. Essentially, both of these projects can coexist on my system without me worrying of switching language framework versions, because the version of the framework is contextualized inside the directory, and that's thanks to Asdf. That's it. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. In the next episode, I'll wrap up this series with showing you how I use Git and using GitHub to persist my work. Until next time. See ya.